Let us discuss the solution of wave equation when initial and boundary conditions are given. We have the one-dimensional wave equation as dou square y by dou t square is equal to c square into dou square y by dou x square, where y x t is the deflection of the string. Since the string is fixed at ends x equal to 0 and x equal to L, there is no displacement for the function for the point at x is equal to 0. Therefore, at x equal to 0, yxt becomes y of 0 t. And since there is no displacement for this point, since it is tied, the value of displacement is equal to 0 at any time. Now, at x equal to L, that is at the second end point, again the value of the displacement is y of Lt, and since the second end point is also tied, there is no displacement for this point at any time, therefore yLt is equal to 0. And the motion of the string depends on the initial deflection and the initial velocity also. Initial deflection is measured at t equal to 0. Also, initial velocity is measured at t equal to 0. Now, whenever we have the function evaluated yxt at t equal to 0, it is going to be purely a function of x. We label it as f of x. That will be given in the problem. Now, if we differentiate yxt with respect to t, then dou y by dou t is again function of x and t. If we evaluate the same at the point t equal to 0, again we are going to get a variable, a function of the variable x alone. Let it be denoted by g of x. Now we are going to see the solution of wave equation whenever these conditions are satisfied. First, let us take the condition that y of 0 t equal to 0. And the solution that is obtained from the method of separation of variables is given by y x t is equal to c1 cos px plus c2 sin px into c3 cos pct plus c4 sin pct. When we evaluate y of 0 t, we can substitute x is equal to 0 in this expression. And we get cos 0 in the first and the second term. And we know that cos 0 is 0 and cos 0 is 1 and sin 0 is 0. Therefore, the term becomes c1 into 1 plus c2 into 0. That is c1 into c3 cos cpt plus c4 sin cpt is equal to 0. Now, this c3 cos cpt plus c4 sin cpt cannot be equal to 0, because if c3 cos cpt plus c4 sin cpt is equal to 0, yxt will automatically become 0, which will lead to a trivial solution of the wave equation. Trivial solution means zero solution. Zero solution is always a solution. We are interested in a non-zero solution. Therefore, this term cannot be equal to 0. Hence, the only possibility is C1 is equal to 0. Since C1 is equal to 0, yxt reduces to C2 sin px into C3 cos cpt plus C4 sin cpt. Now we apply the second boundary condition, that is yLt is equal to 0. Let us substitute x equal to L in this expression. We get C2 sin PL into C3 cos CPT plus C4 sin CPT is equal to 0. Now, as we have discussed earlier, this term cannot be equal to 0, and C2 also cannot be equal to 0, because if C2 is equal to 0, again this solution leads to trivial solution, we will not get a non-zero solution. Therefore, we cannot have C2 is equal to 0. The only possibility is sine PL is equal to 0. Now we know that sine x is equal to 0 whenever x is of the form n pi, where n is an integer 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Therefore, sine PL is equal to 0 implies that PL is of the form n pi, where n can take integer value 0, 1, 2, etc. Therefore, P is evaluated by n pi by L, where n can take values 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Therefore, our solution in equation 6 reduces to yxt is equal to c1 sine px reduces to n pi by L into x into c3 cos cpt reduces to c3 cos c into n pi by L t plus c4 sine c into n pi by L into t. We are taking only n equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. 4, because if we take n is equal to 0, this term is going to be sine 0x. Again, we will get a zero solution. Therefore, to get a non-zero solution, we are taking only n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. up to infinity. Now, let us open the bracket by multiplying these C2 into inside the bracket. We will get the solution as C2 into C3 cos n pi ct by L plus C2 into C4 into sin n pi ct by L into sin n pi x by L. Now let us call this constant C2 into C3 as An and the constant C2 into C4 as Bn. We call it as An because for different values of n, these constants changes. Therefore, corresponding to n, this constant also changes. That's why we have denoted it by An and Bn. After giving this substitution, the solution reduces to yxt is equal to An cos n pi ct by L plus Bn sin n pi ct by L into sin n pi x by L, where An and Bn are arbitrary constants. Still, we have two more arbitrary constants. To eliminate these arbitrary constants, we are using the initial conditions which are given in the problem. And since yxt is of the form An into cos n pi ct by L plus Bn into sin n pi ct by L into sin n pi x by L for n takes values 1, 2, 3, etc., and each solutions are independent to each other, the general solution of yxt, the general solution of the wave equation, can be given by sigma n equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi ct by L plus bn sin n pi ct by L into sin n pi x by L, because of the superposition principle. If y1, y2, y3, etc., yn are n independent solutions of a differential equation, then the general solution of the differential equation is given by c1 y1 plus c2 y2 plus etc. plus cn yn, or it can be represented as sigma I equal to 1 to n ci yi. Here n can vary up to infinity. Therefore, we have the summation varying from n equal to 1 to infinity. Now we have the general solution of the wave equation is given by sigma n equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi ct by L plus bn sin n pi ct by L into sin n pi x by L. Now we have two initial conditions also. The first initial condition is the initial displacement function is f of x. Initial displacement function means the displacement function at time t equal to 0, which is denoted by y of x 0 equal to f of x for some function f of x. Let us evaluate y of x 0 from equation 8, that is the general solution. Then we will get cos 0 at this term, sin 0 at this term, and the remaining terms. We know that cos 0 is equal to 1 and sin 0 is equal to 0. Therefore, this term reduces to 0 and this term reduces to an into 1 into sin n pi x by l. That is, we have f of x equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity an sin n pi x by l. If we observe this series expression, we can see that this expression is the Fourier half range Fourier sine series for the function f of x. And by the equation of the half range Fourier sine series, an can be evaluated by the formula an is equal to 2 by l into integral 0 to l f of x into sin n pi x by l dx. Now we differentiate equation 8, that is the general solution of the partial differential equation, with respect to t to get dou y by dou t. While I differentiate, the left hand side becomes dou y by dou t. And on the right hand side, the first term was an into cos n pi ct by l. While I differentiate this term partially with respect to t, I will get an as a constant into integral of cos u is minus sin u. Instead of u, we have n pi ct by l divided by u dash, or derivative of u, or derivative of n pi ct by l with respect to t, that is n pi c divided by l. Analogously, while I differentiate the term bn into sin n pi ct by l with respect to t, I will get bn into integral of sin is cos n pi ct by l divided by derivative of n pi ct by l, that is n pi c divided by l. Substituting these values, we will get dou y by dou t is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity minus an sin n pi ct by l into n pi c by l plus bn into cos n pi ct by l into n pi c by l. Now let us evaluate dou y by dou t at t equal to 0, and it is given that the value of the expression is equal to g of x. We can substitute the value on the left hand side and evaluate the right hand side. Sigma n equal to 1 to infinity. Here the term sin becomes sin 0, which is equal to 0. Hence this term reduced to 0. This term becomes cos 0, which is 1. Therefore we have bn into 1. Therefore bn into 1 into n pi c by l. Therefore this full term reduces to n pi c by l into bn into the term sin n pi x by l. Now we can see that this series expression, the right hand side is the Fourier series expression of the function g of x, where this term, if I call it as n pi c by l into capital bn, and if I denote it as small bn, I can rewrite the summation as g of x is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin n pi x by l. This is the half range Fourier sine series of g of x. Then small bn can be evaluated by the formula 2 by l into integral 0 to l g of x into sin n pi x by l dx. But small bn was n pi c divided by l into capital bn. Therefore we can substitute for small bn, that is n pi c by l into capital bn is equal to 2 by l into integral 0 to l g of x into sin n pi x by l dx. Therefore bn is given by cross multiplying the right hand side by L by N pi C. L will be cancelled and it will reduce to 2 by N pi C into integral 0 to L g of x into sin N pi x by L dx. That is, we have got the equation to evaluate capital Bn also. Therefore, the final solution of the wave equation is given by equation 8, that is y of x t is equal to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity an cos n pi c t by L plus bn sin n pi c t by L into sin n pi x by L, where an is evaluated by the formula 2 by L into integral 0 to L f of x sin n pi x by L dx, and bn is evaluated by the formula bn is equal to 2 by n pi c into integral 0 to L g of x into sin n pi x by L dx. That is what we have written over here, the most general solution of the wave equation with the initial conditions y at 0 equal to f of x, dou y by dou t at t equal to 0 equal to g of x, and the initial and the boundary conditions y of 0 t equal to y of l t equal to 0 is given by y x t is equal to sigma an cos n pi c t by L plus bn sin n pi c t by L into sin n pi x by L, where an is calculated by 2 by L into integral 0 to L f of x into sin n pi x by L dx, and bn is calculated by the formula 2 by n pi c into integral 0 to L g of x into sin n pi x by L dx.